Hey there, and welcome back to our YouTube channel. In this video, we're going to show you how to build a legal case manager using our amazing app, Softr. A legal case manager should centralize all of the case data, host resources and client information, and be useful for billing, tracking hours, and producing fees. This optimizes the workflow of all employees. The idea is that you should keep all of the information in one place, making it much easier to manage. Lawyers can use this software to gather insights from the past and improve results for the future. Legal case managers usually share the same kind of features, and in this video, we're going to show you how our amazing legal case manager works when you download that free template from softr.io's website. So on our website, you'll see that there is this legal case management template. You can find the link down below. And as always, you can either preview it or use the template. We're going to click use template to get things kicked off in my own Softr app. So I press use template connected to a data source, in this case, my Airtable, and then copy the base to my account. I'm going to add my base, and you can see that there are a few different table databases here. So first of all, we have members. So that would be the different members, whether it be internal or external, as lawyers or clients. Cases, so the specific cases that are attached to lawyers or contacts. And it is grouped in this Airtable base by the status. And then we have contacts. So contacts are going to be clients, opposing counsel, opposing party, the judge, experts, or co-counsel. And all of these different contacts are going to have cases related to them. And then for billing, this is going to be the different billing and hours worked associated with something like case one, Beck Barnacle, who had 45 hours worked at this $700 an hour billing rate. And this is the cost associated to it. And then last but not least, we have case documents. So they're going to be important documents related to cases. And we have a base in here that reflects that. As you can see in this preview, by clicking on login, we have two different user groups. We have one for Jonas, who is a lawyer, and one who is Kat, who is a client. So these are going to be two different views. So if I go into the lawyer view, what pops out to me first is that the two different pages, whether it be the lawyer view or the client view, are going to be very different. So for the lawyer view, I'm going to have cases that are showcased in this board view based on the different stages that they're in. I can move these through the different stages just like this. However, on the client view, I'm just going to see literally my cases. As a client, by clicking within the case, you're going to be able to see the different information on it in the case details page, and then add different documents within here. So this, for example, is going to have the document name. You can upload the document file, and then down here you can do the same thing. You can add a new document name. Now, I don't want to spill any coffee on top of my legal case documents, and I don't want to mess up my legal case documents by having the client not accurately be represented when they submit the form. So something that I definitely recommend you do is in the case details page, utilize something from Softr called hidden fields. You scroll down to this form, you'll see that this is going to send the information to the data source legal case management. And there is a hidden field within here where it maps the case to record ID, but also what would be good is if there was a reason that you wanted to connect the document to anything else, like the actual person who submitted it, you can do that as well by adding a field and then utilizing another hidden field to connect that person to it, just so that we keep track of who actually submitted these documents. If you wanted to set up a hidden field to track who was the person that actually submitted the document, what you could do is, for example, just put a single line text, submitter email, or you can change this to email. You can do a name or an email, for example, and then create the field. And then within your Softr app, after refreshing, what you can do is you could set the form to capture the logged in person's email or name by creating a hidden field that captures the submitter email in the map to, and goes to logged in users email. And then let's publish this and open it in a new tab, so that when I would enter a new document here, very important document, I could put in a example document here, press save document. And then we'd see within here that it would have captured this document and the email of the person who submitted it. Now, when taking a closer look, we can see that this template has even more information. Not only do we have the cases at the top, we can also see a billing overview. So all the cases and their billing till date. So we have all this, there's a lot of billing here. I mean, lawyers, you know, no comment. But seriously, you can click into any of these cases and see the information and case documents very similar to what you had with the view from a client point of view. And then by clicking on cases at the top, we also can add new cases and filter it out by the different types, the different statuses. And as you'll notice in the back end, this actually does show all of the different cases. But if I wanted to, I could duplicate this and filter it with a conditional filter to have the lawyer is one of, and then logged in user's name. So by publishing this and going to view that, we would see the different ones for this wonderful gentleman right here. So at the bottom, if I scroll down, this would be the ones that's just for Jonas. And we can still filter and click into any of these or add new cases, view the documents and view the information with these. And then the same thing from the client side. This is just gonna show a conditional filter to what the clients are for Jonas. And if I click into any of them, it's gonna have a side view that showcases the different client details and what cases are associated to those clients. And I can quickly and easily update the different client information by clicking on here. And last but not least, this lawyers page is gonna give you a view of all the different lawyers that are in this case manager and showcase them by specialty. So if I wanted to just see criminal lawyers, I can. If I wanted to just look for ones named Natalie, I can do that. So I'll be able to see their rate, their contact information, and their specialty. And if I click on them, I'm also gonna have the information more in depth, how many cases in total, what their total build amount is. And then if I scroll down, I'll see the different cases they've handled and quickly and easily be able to open up that case information by clicking there. This is one of the most interconnected and easy to use templates inside of Softr. I'm a huge fan of the way that it flows and how easily you're able to manage workflows as a lawyer or client inside of the legal case manager. So if you want to get this template, make sure to check out the link down below. And if you learned anything, make sure to smash that like button. Just absolutely destroy it. And check out more videos like this one on how to improve at your skills using Softr even more.